Namaskar. All we humans are born with certain traits. Right from childhood, you will find a child. Some child gets afraid very fast. Some child worries very much. Some child gets angry very fast. Some reacts very fast. So you will find these traits right from the beginning. And we have noticed that worried and getting afraid, little things that then fear comes into personality. This type of nature, getting afraid of little things, when it is not controlled, it can really go to the extent that it can cause attacks, which is called as panic attacks, and that is extreme. When person has panic attack, person's heart starts pounding very fast. Heart beats so fast that you feel that heart is going to jump out of your body. That state comes in. Person is sweating profusely. Person is shaking as if you are shivering. Person is getting blank totally. Mind is totally blank. No thought. Everything freezes. And a fear of death comes in. A fear of losing something comes in. And that makes the whole personality totally into a state which you would call as a statue. Nothing moves. It's like you are nothing else but a dead standing in front. It goes to that extent. And that is very harmful, because with such panic attack, you will notice that every muscle of our body goes into stress. First of all, understand what to do when such attack comes. We have to learn to manage this attack and slowly learn to prevent. First of all, mind has to be again alert. You should close your eyes. Don't see here and there and everywhere. There may be a little cockroach, there may be a lizard, but you close your eyes. Close your eyes and relax and have a very slow, equal breathing. Breathe in for 2 seconds, breathe out for 2 seconds. Little bit relaxing. Heart is pumping fast. Relax your body. Relax every part of your body. And that is the first thing you should do. Second, concentrate on your abdomen. Because that tension is received in abdomen first. Abdomen becomes tight. Arteries become narrow. Blood pressure shoots up. And so what you should do is focus on abdomen and relax your abdomen. And here is our pranayama number 4. Breathe in, your abdomen goes up a bit. Breathe out, bring it down. Do this for 2-3 minutes, 5 minutes, sitting. If you can lie down, lying down. But do this abdominal breathing, and that would really bring confidence in you, little joy in you and cheer in you. Once a person gets panic attack, then that person always lives under that fear. His entire behavior changes. He is always afraid not to face the same situation again. I know a person who gets panic attack when he is at the height. So in the airplane, when he sits in the plane, he just cannot manage and he is into a very bad state. So when he came to me, I told him it's very simple. All these things are nothing else but a state of mind. If you know how to keep your mind occupied in something healthy, mind will not bring any attack anymore. So what you should do is, before you enter the plane, you should have some subject in your mind that you are going to write an essay on something, Indian food or anything. And that subject is in your mind. You are sitting, plane starts, plane flies, but you are busy thinking, writing, closing your eyes, thinking again. So here what you have done, you have given some work to your mind. Free mind attack is going to come, because that's your nature. And so we should be handling our mind very nicely. And you can handle, it's not difficult. And that person did that and he was so happy. He came out victoriously when the plane landed. He says, well, I didn't have any panic attack. So understand that many such things bother us in life. Darkness. People just can't manage darkness. They get panicked. something will come. And nowadays that little children, they talk about bhoot aayega in darkness. So such things have to be handled. Person has to keep darkness in mind. All create darkness. Close your eyes and walk. So you have created darkness. So darkness is your friend. You can't have a fear. Very often during day, you should close your eyes and walk. So even at night in dark room, first the room was light, had light. Now you close your eyes, start walking, switch off the light. You are in dark and yet you are walking very happily. The fear goes away. So this type of an effort we'll have to put with every such subjects. Everybody has a list of what are the things which makes them afraid. What are the things which they don't want now anymore in their life? They should make a list. And one by one, all these things have to be removed from your system. We'll have to put an effort. Otherwise, these things will come. Now, I give you one story. There was a mummy deer. She was about to deliver baby. So she walked and came near a pond and made the place little clear. And when she was coming near the pond, fire broke in jungle. Jungle was burning. She saw that, but now she sat. And then when she looked on right side, she found a tiger has been looking at her. And that was a big danger. So she looked on the left side and she saw that a hunter is pointing out at her. He was focusing on her. Everywhere there was a danger. Behind fire, tiger on one side, hunter on another side, in front water. But she just looked down. She just delivered the baby and started caressing the baby very peacefully. Her whole mind was focused on that little one, baby. She was totally in a present tense and doing her job there. And nature takes its own turn. And what happened was in this story that there was a thunder and lightning and very heavy shower started coming. So the fire was extinguished from the back. And because of that lightning, this hunter's arrow couldn't hit the target. It went little different way and that thing hit the tiger. So tiger shouted, looked at hunter, and both of them, they ran away. And here is mother who is sitting, carrying the baby and slowly walking back in jungle. So now this whole story teaches us very big lesson. Problems are there around. We get panicked, but instead of getting panicked, we should focus on present. Right now, what am I supposed to do? My heart is pounding. Take one or two long breaths. I'm not breathing correctly. One or two long breaths. I should just relax my body because body is under tension. I should walk. Do something. Something has to be done in present. Not to think about the problems, but think about the solution. And solution is always in present tense, not in past or future. So this habit we have to find, that we have to learn to be in present. So take charge of yourself, take care, learn yoga properly, absorb yoga into your life and become strong, capable, confident personality. Namaskar.